from the Storm Team Weather Lab, KMAC Chief Meteorologist Ron Roberts.
Okay, I've got one for Lauren because she pays close attention every time we do the forecast here from the KMAC 28 Storm Team Weather Lab, and I want to ask her, where's the front? The cool front.
Take a look
at this. It's going to show up. Take a look. And look real close, Lauren, and what do you see? Where's the cool front?
By Dallas.
Dallas.
Amarillo. I don't know.
Oh, did you say Amarillo?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. This is the colder air with the dry front moved through this morning. And, of course, took with it all the precipitation, which we anticipated. But this is the wraparound front that's now south of Amarillo, moving toward Happy and the northern half of the South Plains and the Lubbock area. This front is going to move through tonight. If you have plans tonight, keep in mind the wind will decrease and the temperatures are not that bad right now, but the wind will shift to the north and will become a little cooler. So sweater perhaps later on. And the wind is still a bit gusty with the front. Notice the wind direction, north, 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 north versus west. So Lauren got it. I mean, the front's now in plain view and the wind just now beginning to back a little bit more in the Lubbock area from the west to the northwest to north. So the front is going to be here for this evening and it will cool us off. Now temperatures did jump quite a bit and really a no duh, right? Because we were with clouds and rain yesterday. Shallow water live sky view. Yeah, looking toward the west, or rather the east and northeast and clouds and the front beginning to move into the northern half of the metro. Let's see if we can find it here on the live weather sensors and in Plainview and Rawls. Rawls 58, the wind's north northwest in Rawls. Wolford's 58 degrees too, north northwest. These are wind ahead of the front. 59 degrees, 82nd in Quaker. Brownfield 61 degrees, more of a west wind. But Plainview is 54 degrees, north wind at about 12 miles per hour. So yeah, the front is dropped the temperatures about 4 or 5 degrees so far. All right, so the jet stream, here's your weather system. This little dip, when we call this, a trough axis, and this trough axis is gonna take this system away from us pretty quickly, all right? A little bit of a jet stream max into the area. After that, we see this ridge out west. What's a ridge? Well, it's upside down horseshoe, if you will. And because of that high pressure system that's going to be building over the weekend, temperatures will have an opportunity to warm up, more sunshine on the way. That's how we'll see it. So 6 to 10 day outlook showing above average precipitate temperatures across most of the country, except here. And here's why. After the ridge moves east of us in the 6 to 10 day period, some moisture is going to return to the west. That could include parts of our area. At this point, we still look to be above average. And that precipitation, here we go. Above average precipitation for the area as we get past the 6 to 10 day. Again, with the trough here, you have moisture producing some rain. We'll see how that pans out next week. As far as Dora is concerned, she hopes it happens. Got herself a rain gauge from Mr. Wildcat, the Rolly man himself. And the forecast for hour by hour. Again, if you're going to be out this evening, notice temperatures mid upper 30s right into about 3 o'clock. 35 in the morning, and we're back to 49 by lunchtime. Low temperature tonight, 32. The wind becomes a little bit more light than what it was earlier today. I had to go back in and kind of work on my hair a little bit, kind of messed up a couple of my hairs here. 55, 62.
You can't even tell.
68 degrees. I know you can't.
Good hairspray.
What?
I said you have good hairspray.
Oh, no, I don't have to wear any of that.
Naturally,
looks good.
Really? Impressive. Okay, Ron, thank you.